Choosing the right projection when selecting data with JPA and Hibernate is incredibly important. When I'm working with a coaching client to improve the performance of their application, we always work on slow queries. At least 80% of them can be tremendously improved by either adjusting the projection or by using the correct fetch type. Unfortunately, changing the projection of an existing query always requires a lot of refactoring in your business code. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org, and in this video, I will explain the basic rules you should follow to always pick the right projection for your use case. But before we proceed, if you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, now that you've done that, let's quickly explain what a projection is. The projection describes which columns you select from your database and in which form Hibernate provides them to you. Or in other words, if you're writing a JPQA query, like you see here, it's everything between the select and the from keywords. JPA and Hibernate support three groups of projections: scalar values, entities, and DTOs. SQL only supports scalar projections, like table columns or the return value of a database function. So, how can JPA and Hibernate support more projections? Hibernate first checks which information it needs to retrieve from the database and generates an SQL statement with a scalar value projection for it. It then executes the query and returns the result if you use the scalar value projection in your code. If you requested a DTO or entity projection, Hibernate applies an additional transformation step. It iterates through the result set and instantiates an entity or a DTO object for each record. Let's take a closer look at our three projections in the IDE and discuss when you should use which of them. For most teams, entities are the most common projection. They are very easy to use with JPA and Hibernate. You can either use the find method on your entity manager or write a simple JPQL or criteria query that selects one or more entities. Spring Data JPA can even derive a query that returns an entity from the name of your repository method. All entities that you load from the database or retrieve from one of Hibernate's caches are in the lifecycle state managed. That means that your persistence provider, for example Hibernate, will automatically update or remove the corresponding database record if you change the value of an entity attribute or decide to remove the entity. Entities are the only projection that has a managed lifecycle state. Whenever you want to implement a write operation, you should fetch entities from the database. They make the implementation of write operations much easier and often even provide performance optimizations. But if you implement a read-only use case, you should prefer a different projection. Managing the lifecycle state, ensuring that there's only one entity object for each managed database record within a session, and all the other features provided by Hibernate create an overhead. This overhead makes the entity projection slower than a scalar value or DTO projection. Scalar value projections avoid the management overhead of entity projections, but they are not very comfortable to use. Hibernate doesn't transform the result of the query. You therefore get an object or an object array as the result of your query. In the next step, you will then need to iterate through each record in your result set and cast each object to its specific type before you can use it. That makes your code error-prone and hard to read. Instead of an object array, you can also retrieve a scalar projection as a tuple interface. The interface is a little easier to use than the object array, but don't expect too much. It only provides a few additional methods to retrieve an element, for example by its alias. But the returned values are still of type object, and your code is still as error-prone as it is if you use an object array. Scalar value projections are not limited to singular entity attributes. You can also include the return values of one or more database functions. This is a huge advantage compared to an entity projection. If you use an entity projection in the previous example, you would need to select all book entities with their associated author entity. In the next step, you would then need to count the number of books each author has written and calculate the total and average sales values. As you can see in the code snippet, using a database function is easier and it also provides better performance. DTO projections are the best kind of projection for read-only operations. Hibernate instantiates the DTO objects as a post-processing step after it retrieved the query result from the database. It then iterates through the result set and executes the describe constructor call for each record. Here you can see a simple example of a JPQA query that returns the query result as a list of book DTO objects. By using the keyword new and providing the fully qualified class name of your DTO class and an array of references to entity attributes, you can define a constructor call. Hibernate will then use reflection to call this constructor. In contrast to the entity projection, the overhead of DTO projection is minimal. The objects are not part of the current persistence context and don't follow any managed lifecycle. Due to that, Hibernate will not generate any SQL update statements if you change the value of a DTO attribute. But it also doesn't have to spend any management effort, which provides significant performance benefits. Similar to scalar value projections, you can also use database functions in a DTO projection. As explained earlier, the instantiation of the DTO object is a post-processing step after Hibernate retrieved the query result. At that phase, it doesn't make any difference if a value was stored in a database column or if it was calculated by a database function. Hibernate simply gets it from the result set and provides it as a constructor parameter. JPA and Hibernate support three groups of projections. Entities are the easiest and most common projection. They are a great fit if you need to change data, but they are not the most efficient ones for read-only use cases. Scalar projections are returned as object arrays or instances of the tuple interface. Both versions don't provide any type information and are hard to use. Even though they are very efficient for read-only operations, you should avoid them in your application. DTO projections provide similar performance as scalar value projections, but are much easier to use. That makes them the best projection for read-only operations. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!